Did you know you have a powerful assistant living in your pocket and your home, just waiting to help with your day? Google Assistant is a powerful tool that a surprising amount of people don't make use of to its full potential. This is even more surprising when you think that almost everyone now has a mobile phone, and a lot of homes also have at least one Google Home device. It can help organize your day, alleviating you from having to remember every single aspect of your daily agenda. Just like a real assistant, it will manage the minutiae of your schedule, enabling you to focus on getting the important things done, whether it's just for your home life or even for work. There are a number of invaluable features that come free just by owning an Android phone or using the Google Home app on your iPhone, and one of the more powerful features is routines. Routines are essentially a way to automate virtual tasks that will be triggered either by time or a verbal prompt. The benefit to a routine over just asking Google Assistant to do individual tasks is that you can say the command once. If you own other smart devices in your home that are compatible with Google Assistant, your routines can also control them too. Turning off lights, locking or unlocking your doors, setting the temperature on your smart thermostat, and even activating your robot vacuum cleaner. Routines come in several preset variations, but you can also create bespoke routines custom built for your own unique requirements. The average person will probably find the default routines useful enough by themselves. For instance, the Good Morning routine comes with three preset actions that will tell you the latest weather report, read out your agenda on your calendar, as well as your reminders. However, the team at Google has also added a section you'll find at the bottom called Suggested Actions. This is a short list of some of the more creative or sophisticated additional actions that you can do. One of my favorites is the Workday routine, which I've set to automatically start at the beginning of each weekday. Within this routine, I've broken out into time slots, from the morning through to the end of the day. Another useful routine I've set up is one for bedtime and my kids. Now, with a single command, I can turn off the light and play their favorite bedtime song. Talking of which, what I find particularly impressive is the ability to choose a specific song using the YouTube Music database. However, you're not limited to just music, with shortcuts to news, radio stations, podcasts, audiobooks, or even relaxation sounds. To start creating the routine, open the Google Home app and tap your profile picture. Then tap Assistant Settings. Scroll down to Routines. From there, you can see some of the preset routines, including the section called Workday. The first step is to pick which device you want your announcements to broadcast on. Now choose the days of the week that you want the routine to run. For me, I keep a Monday to Friday schedule. Next, select a time that you want your first announcement to broadcast. My workday starts at 9 a.m. After that, go to Browse Popular Actions and tap on Tell Me the Time, which will announce the time at 9 a.m. As part of my daily prep, I like to know what kind of weather we're going to have. Tap Weather in the list of actions and it'll announce the day's forecast. I also want to know what today's reminders and today's calendar entries are. After I've done that, I want to add a new time for lunch starting at 11:30 a.m. Tap on Say Something to add your own personalized messages. One cool feature is that you can write your own custom message, which Google Assistant will read out.
The time is 11:30 a.m. It's lunchtime.
Next, I like to take a break in the afternoon. Just like before, choose a time and then again, browse popular actions and tap Tell Me the Time. I also want to know if there's any remaining reminders, and I'll create a custom message by tapping Say Something. For the final part of the routine, I have a prompt to start thinking about finishing my day at 4:30 p.m. Like before, I want Google Assistant to announce the time with a custom message, but this time I also want it to tell me about tomorrow's first calendar entry, just to prep me for the next day. And that's my basic workday routine to keep productive but also take regular breaks. One limitation right now is that routines can't be triggered by location. Unlike reminders or Google Keep entries, Google Assistant doesn't have the ability to start your I'm home routine the moment you pull into the driveway. Another thing I noticed was that the scene selection for your lights is unusable if you're using Philips Hue. It lumps all the various Hue lights into an unmanageable generic list, and you're unable to easily ascertain which scene corresponds to which light without some trial and error. Another frustration is that Google recently introduced new shortcut routines. In theory, these enable you to start a specific action in an app like Twitter to create a tweet or Gmail to create an email. However, the Show Me My Orders for Amazon command launches Amazon.com rather than Amazon.ca, which is a pain for me personally living in Canada. Finally, one additional bugbear is the fact that you can't set your routine to trigger on multiple devices. I would personally find it helpful as I'm not always near my Google Nest Hub at my desk. I might be making breakfast in the kitchen or doing something else around the house, which would mean I'd miss out on my updates, which is a little inconvenient. Leave a comment if you have any personal frustrations, or even if you think that my examples have been fixed since recording this. Despite all the minor gripes, it should be noted that the Google ecosystem is constantly being updated, and with AI and the assistant being a cornerstone of Google's business focus right now, you can pretty much guarantee that further improvements, bug fixes, and features are on the horizon. If you made it this far, I hope you found it interesting and informative. Please like the video and subscribe to my channel for future content about the connected home and personal technology.